Hello guys, so we are starting with how to protect yourself against cybercrime. So are you concerned about cybercrime? So here we will understand what exactly the cybercrime is and what are the different types of cybercrime and how we can protect ourselves from it. So below are the four main focus areas which we will cover. So what is cybercrime, types of cybercrime, what counts as a cybercrime with examples and how to protect yourself against the cybercrime. So what is cybercrime? So cybercrime is any crime that takes place online. Anything happens online is fall under the cybercrime. So cybercriminals often commit crimes by targeting computer networks or their devices. Cybercrime can range from security breaches to identity theft. Other cybercrimes include things like cyber stalking, harassment, bullying, and the child sexual exploitation. So terrorists collaborate on the internet, moving terrorist activity and crime into cyberspaces are known majorly as a cybercrime. So let's talk about these types of cybercrime. So in the types here below are the some different types of cybercrimes which we will cover. So email and the internet frauds, identity frauds where personal information is stolen and used, theft and the sale of corporate data, theft of card payment data or financial data, ransomware attacks, a type of cyber extortion. And cyber extortion means demanding money to prevent a threatened back attack. And cyber spying, where hackers access government or the company data. And cryptojacking, where hackers mine cryptocurrency using the resources they do not own. So these are the types. So now talking about the examples of cybercrimes. So exactly what counts as a cybercrime? And are there any well-known examples? So yes, below are that. So first is the malware attacks. So a malware attack is a attack where a computer system or a network is infected with a computer virus or other types of malware. A famous example of malware attack is the WannaCry ransomware attack. A global cybercrime committee in May 2017 found that, and when the WannaCry ransomware attacks hits the computer or the networks, so mostly around 230,000 computers were affected across 150 countries. So users were blocked out of their files and sent a message demanding that they pay a Bitcoin ransom to regain their access. So second is the phishing attack. A phishing campaign is when spam emails or other forms of communication are sent emails with the intention to tricking recipient into doing something that that their security undermines that security or the security of the organization they work for. So distributed denial of service is the third one, in which types of cybercrime attackers tries to bring down a system or the network, sometimes connected to IoT, Internet of Things, devices are used to launch the DDoS attack. So now move further, how to protect yourself against the cybercrime? So what are the best ways to protect yourself or your computers from these kind of cybercrimes and to protect your personal data there? So below are some tips like keep software and the operating system up to date. You have to update your Windows operating system, any software application, mobile application you are using, so that it's having all the latest security patches to protect your computer or device. Second is the manage your social media settings. Keep your personal and the private information locked down. Social engineering is the another cyber criminal activity which gets your personal information with just a few data points. So the less you share publicly, the better for you. So for instance, if you post your pet's name or reveal your mother's middle name, you might expose the answer to two common security questions, which asked mainly by website or the applications during your registration or to recover your emails. So you have to take care about it. So we can use antivirus software and keep it updated. Use an antivirus, mostly the paid ones that are very useful to secure your internet activities which you are doing in your computer, laptops or your mobile phones. So this will save you from these kind of attacks. So use a strong password. Be sure that to use a strong password that the people will not guess, and do not record them anywhere. Do not write down or save a soft copy in your laptop or the PC. Use a reputable password manager to generate a strong password randomly to make this easier. And the password manager will manage all your passwords, so you don't have to worry about it. Never open an attachment in spam emails. A classic way that computer gets infected by malware attacks and the other form of Cyber crime is a via email attachment in spam emails. Never open an attachment from a sender you do not know. So just delete that mail without opening that. Likely lucky draw you are getting. So these kind of spam mails you are on the daily basis you are getting. So do not open that. And do not click on the links in spam emails or untrusted websites. Another way people become victim of cybercrime is by clicking on the links in spam emails or other messages or unfamiliar websites. Avoid doing this to stay safe online. So you have to protect yourself. So we can guide you, but at the end security is from your side. So do not give out personal information unless secure. Never give out personal data, your payment card, debit card, credit card data. Whenever you see that browser is showing this application is, this website is not secure. So please ask to the person first that you are on the genuine side, else please don't share your personal data on these kind of unsafe websites. Be mindful of which website URL you visit. Keep an eye on the URL you are clicking. Do not look legitimate. So do they look legitimate? Avoid click on these links and with unfamiliar or spammy looking URLs. So if you are opening any website, then please cross check this is the original website you are visiting, else avoid that clicking on those links to stay safe and secure. And the last one is the contact companies directly about suspicious request. If you get asked for data from a company who has called you, hang up. Call them back using the number on their official website to ensure that you are speaking to them on the legitimate person and you are talking to the genuine company person for the support care you are having, and do not share your personal information there. So all you have to take care about these kind of basic things so that you can stay safe and secure on the internet, because nowadays cyber crimes are increasing day by day and that will harm you and steal your personal data or can harass you on online basis by sending you the mails or the messages that we have this kind of data, so you have to pay this amount. So you have to take care about that. So last thing, stay safe, stay secure, and we will focus on the security. So this is the awareness video, so we are thinking to explore more other things also in the future. So if you want to share, you can share that video, and thank you for patience and stay safe, stay secure there. So that's it from my side. So thank you so much guys, that's it for today. Thank you.